So guess what? An herbalist hired me to grow one of the strangest herbs I've ever had in my hydroponic greenhouse. It smells like medicine, and absinthe had a baby. It's traditionally used in parasite cleanses and digestive bitters. And after a few harvests, they've already hired me to grow another full round. So today I'm taking you from tiny seeds to hydroponic jungle to a dried herb ready for tinctures and herbal remedies. So if you ever wondered how to grow powerful medicinal herbs in a clean, controlled hydroponic system, this is going to be a fun, slightly weird one. Hey friends, welcome back to Homegrown Passion. I'm Katie, and today we're hanging out in the greenhouse with a silvery, wild-looking plant called wormwood, or Artemisia absinthium. That's how you say it, I'm not sure. A local herbalist reached out and said, Katie, I love how clean your hydroponic setup is, and would you be willing to grow wormwood for our tinctures and our blends? And so I said yes, and I started a test run in the hydro. And the first one went so well, they've already given me another contract to grow even more. Now, a quick but important note before we dive into details. Wormwood is a strong medicinal herb. It's famous as a traditional ingredient in absinthe, vermouth, and herbal bitters, and is often used by herbalists in parasite protocols and digestive formulas. But it also contains a compound called thojon, which can be toxic in large amounts or if you have certain health conditions, and is not recommended in pregnancy or for kids. So this video is not medical advice. I'm just showing you how to grow a very potent herb in a hydroponic system for a trained herbalist. If you want to use wormwood internally, please work with a qualified herbal practitioner or a healthcare provider. The wormwood isn't something you're going to find as a six-pack at the garden center, but it actually starts really easily from seed. The first big thing to know is that wormwood seeds need light to germinate, so you don't want to bury them deep if you're going to grow them in soil. So here's what I do in the greenhouse. When I went on the internet to see where I could purchase wormwood seeds, they're everywhere, so it was very easy to find them for sale. So I did order some, and they came, but the seeds are super tiny. So I'm putting them into my hand, gently, and I'm going to use my tweezer to try to just get two or three into each one of the Oasis cubes. Now I have to make sure I don't cover the cubes because they need the light to germinate, and they need a nice, moist growing medium. So I'm just going to drop a couple in there on each one. And they do take quite a while to germinate. I think it takes about 7 to 21 days. And these have a 97% germination rate, so I'm confident I'm going to have a really good crop. I start with my Oasis cubes, just like I do for all my leafy greens. They're pre-cut, they hold moisture really evenly, and they make it super easy to transplant into the hydroponic system. I pre-soak the cubes with a very light nutrient solution, just enough to wet them, but not dripping wet. Then I sprinkle a few wormwood seeds right into the dimple holes. They are so tiny, so I aim for a few seeds per cell, and I don't cover them. Because they need light, I just mist them in so the seeds make a contact with the cube. And I set the trays under bright light. In my setup, germination has taken about 2 to 3 weeks, so don't panic. They're very slow to germinate. Once the seedlings have their first set of true leaves and the strongest ones is obvious, I just thin each tube to one healthy plant with scissors. From there, they're ready to move into the hydro system. Once the seedlings have a nice little root system coming out of the cubes, I transplant them into the simple hydroponic setup. You can grow wormwood in different systems, but I like using my NFT system hooked up to the same lines I use for my other herbs. A couple of key things about wormwood. In soil, it loves full sun and very well drained, even lean soil. So in hydro, I treat it like it prefers. Bright light, not too rich of a nutrient solution. For nutrients, I run a balanced hydroponic nutrient with the EC on the low to moderate side compared to my heavy feeders and a pH in the 5.8 range. You definitely don't have to copy my exact numbers, but I think herbs like it a bit lean, not tomatoes that want to be spoiled. I space the plants out a little bit more than I would lettuce because wormwood wants to become bushy like a shrub. If you crowd it, it'll still grow, but if you tighten it up too much, it fights for airflow and light. As the plant settles in, you notice the classic silver-green foliage develop, and the whole area takes on the strong, bitter, almost medicinal smell. And that's when you know it's a very happy plant. Once Wormwood is established in the hydro, it's actually pretty low maintenance. You know, day to day, I'm watching for root health, making sure that they're white to cream color, not brown and slimy. Solution level, I don't want the roots drowning. I want them getting oxygen. That's why I like the NFT system. The growth habit, they'll get really tall and leggy if you let them. Because I'm growing this from Herbalist, I want lots of tender leafy growth, not just all tall woody stems. So early on, I pinch off the tip of the plants, and this has encouraged them to branch out and get even more bushier. That gives me more usable herbs per plant and helps keep them at a manageable height in the greenhouse. Wormwood really likes bright light, so I try to keep it in one of my sunniest spots. If I notice it reaching or stretching, that's my sign that more light or less crowding is needed. The other thing I paid attention to is the smell and the color. Healthy wormwood has that unmistakable bitter aroma and a strong silvery-green color. If it starts yellowing all over, it's either I overdid the nutrients or something is off with the pH. But overall, once it's going, it's a pretty tough little plant. Now let's talk about the harvest, because that's where timing really matters for medicinal herbs. In traditional herb growing, wormwood is usually harvested when it's flowering, because that's when the concentration of its active compounds is highest. In my hydro system, I wait until the plants have build up a good amount of leafy growth, and I see the flowers, buds, and blooms starting to open. And that's my cue. For this herbalist contract, I harvest the top third of the plant, the green, non-woody stems, leaves, and flowers. I use clean, sharp pruners and cut just above a set of side branches so the plant can push out fresh growth for a second round. I gather the cut stems into loose bundles and bring them straight into the headhouse to get them ready for the dehydrator. If you're growing for yourself and not for a contract, you can absolutely harvest smaller amounts more often, but I like doing nice big harvests so I can fill the dehydrator more efficiently, and then it gives the plants more time to regrow. So you can air dry the herbs by hanging them, but because I'm dealing with a potent medicinal plant and I'm doing this for someone else, I prefer the control of my dehydrator. I spread the wormwood stems in a single layer on the trays. I don't want a big thick pile or it'll dry really unevenly. Then I set the dehydrator on its lowest herb setting. And for most dehydrators, it's anywhere between 95 to 105 degrees Fahrenheit. Low and slow helps preserve more of the aromatic compounds. Drying time will depend on how thick your stems are and how packed your trays are, but I'm generally looking at several hours. And the way I test to make sure it's done, the leaves should feel crisp and crumble between your fingers, and the stems should snap instead of bend. And once everything is bone dry, I strip the leaves and the flowers off the stem, because that's the part the herbalist actually uses, and I compost the bare stems. Then I store the dried herbs in a labeled glass jar in a cool, dark place with the name of the plant and the date it went into the jar. Properly dried and stored herbs like this can keep their potency up for 1 or 2 years, which is perfect for someone making tinctures and blends over time. From here, all of this beautiful dried wormwood goes straight to the herbalist who hired me. They'll turn it into things like alcohol-based tinctures, digestive bitters, and carefully formulated herbal blends that may include parasite support depending on their practice and their client's needs. Again, because wormwood is so strong, most reputable herbalist sources are very clear that it needs to be used in small, appropriate doses and avoided by people who are pregnant, breastfeeding, very young, or dealing with certain health conditions like seizure disorders or serious liver or kidney issues. So I'm just happy staying in my lane as the grower. My job is to give this plant a clean, consistent, pesticide-free environment in my hydroponic greenhouse and then hand it off to a professional who knows exactly what they're doing with it. So that's the full journey from tiny seeds on Oasis cubes to silvery shrubs in my hydro system to fragrant, crisp wormwood ready for tinctures and herbal remedies. If you enjoyed this little tour on the weirder side of hydroponics, let me know in the comments. And would you grow a strong medicinal herb in your hydroponic system? Or are you sticking to lettuce and basil for now? If you found this helpful, please hit that like button. And if you're new here, subscribe to my channel, Homegrown Passion, so you don't miss the next video. I've got more hydroponic herb experiments coming, including some general herbs that are easier to use in everyday teas and cookings. So click over and watch this video next, and I'll meet you back in the greenhouse. Thanks for hanging out with me today, and I'll see you in the next one.